peony rubber gloves because mine's burst the other day. Always handy to keep your hands nice and dry. So yeah, that was that. Not anything less like any certain items. I went in and picked some random stuff. So I'll start off with this. So this was $7, and this is a electric face shaver. This is quite good for touching up eyebrows, things like that. So I've used this quite a few times for just touching up eyebrows if you're, you know, you've got a few strays, or if you're away on holiday or something. It's got the tiny little brush at the side, and yeah, you just trim away those wee bits if you don't have, like, you know, pliers, tweezers or stuff like that. Also, I suppose if you've had like the random bits of hair on your chin or anything like that, this is quite handy as well. So this was a $7 one, which is about $3.50. So yeah, it's a bit different prices. I don't know how much this was originally, can't tell. So yeah, $7 for that one. So there are certain items that you do pay a wee bit more for. So that was that. Another thing, these are quite popular in Japan, is the razors for your face. Now I got these ones. These are the longer handles, but you do get the smaller handles, and they do have the little blades on them. So this is for like shaving off, like, you know, the hair fluff, your, like, your peachy hair on the side of your face or whatever. Let's just see if I can open this up, and then if I can get into it. So here's what they look like. So they come in. This is the long handle, which is quite handy to have. You do get shorter ones, which are probably about a wee bit smaller. So you get the cap, which covers the actual blade. And there you go. So you can just see. And then you just scrape that up and down your face. So you would just, you know, scrape that onto your face. And then replace the blade. So you get three in there. Daiso that I got all these, which is good. I picked up this, which is just, I have got a sewing kit, but sometimes, you know, if you're traveling or you're over, you know, going away somewhere, it's always handy just to, I've kind of figured it's always handy just to have these. A couple of times when I've had maybe a button pop out when I've been at work, or a hem's came down. So yeah, I just got this. Quite cheap, and it's quite practical, so folds over, ideal little size. So that was that. I also got one of these, a folding bag hook. So if you're, you know, if you're in bathrooms or that, you'll kind of put your bag on the back of the toilet, but sometimes, depending on where you are, you know, you might not be able to hang it. You know, if you don't want to keep it on the floor or anything. So what you do is you basically just attach that to the table, and then you can hang your bag onto that. So that's quite sturdy, as you can see, that's not going to fall out. And it says that it is up to 5 kg folding bag hook. And the good thing is it just folds in itself. So there you go, that could easily fit. So you could easily just, you know, there you go, you've got two wee things that you can carry around in your bag with you. So that was that. I've got this one, this is quite good. I like this because, one, it's a nice decent size, it's clear inside. I use a lot of bags in my actual day bag. And I like this, and I just want to replace some of them. So this could be for like sanitary products, painkillers, plasters. And with it being red, especially if you're a female, you would be able to pull that out of your bag, and it would have your, like, your, you know, that time of the month stuff in it, and everybody would just assume it's your makeup. So yeah, you know, and it's quite good. It's quite, I mean, it's material on the outside, and inside is in kind of like a waterproof kind of waterproof, but yeah, so that's quite nice again. In sweat pouch flat, so yeah, that would be handy for travelling. I just picked up some random origami paper, 60 sheets. Always fancied it, so I'm going to give that a go, see how that works out. Let me know if you'd like to see a video on that. I have not done origami for years, but I figured, you know, why not? It would be quite interesting. I picked up this little book, which I thought was quite cute. It's just a little notebook. It's covered with a clear covering, so you could probably pop some notes inside here. And it's just a lined book. Nothing fancy, but I just liked the outside of it. So it was quite cute. There was different styles, but yeah, quite like that. It'd be quite handy if you're watching my tarot and oracle videos. I'm going to start pulling like a card a day, an oracle card or a tarot card a day, and then following up on it. So I might actually use this for that. I got these, which I thought were quite good for just in my bag. They're just clear wallets. Mine, but my other ones are kind of getting a bit faded. So they're quite a good size, actually. This one's quite a good size. It's clear. You can probably get like quite a lot in that. I also got this one, which is quite good. It's a smaller one, but again, you could fit, you know, quite good stuff in it. I'll try later on and see how much I can actually get in that. So that was that. Compressed towels. I just bought these because, you know, in case I ever need a random towel somewhere. Ideal for travelling, which I was meant to be doing. Just handy to have a towel. And these ones are, you put them in water and they expand. So I'll do a video on that as well later. This is just a hair turban. Basically, it catches water, but can also be used for keeping your hair back. But it's got the added benefit of keeping in water. I actually might use this while working out for it to actually soak up any sweat or, you know, stuff like that. This is just a random coat hook hanging rack. It's basically just for your trousers or your pants. You hang them over here, hang them in your wardrobe. So yeah, I just got that because I'm in the middle of clearing out my wardrobe and trying to declutter. And this one is another little travel kit that I got. I've got these in my main, like for my hands and nails, but I just figured this would be quite good for just, you know, popping in your bag for, you know, for work or whatever. It's got a little mirror. Comes in a little pouch, so you have a mirror, which is quite a good wee mirror. I can get it out the bag. Quite a good wee mirror. Folds over. You've got your scissors, you've got your tweezers, and you've got like your toe clippers, nail clippers. So yeah, it's a handy dinky wee size, plus it just all folds over and it's all locked in. So yeah, that was quite handy. So that was that. A random hairband, quite like that, because it's just got the little pleated bits on the side. Braided hairband, ideal for makeup, putting your hair back, working out. And it's got the nice rubber bits, you know, it's got the material stained on the end, so you're not really going to be scratching yourself with that. These, you've probably seen these on other videos. It's a compressed facial mask. What I like about these is similar to the towels, you put these instead of into water, you would put them into like your essence or maybe your serum or some form of liquid, and they expand. So you basically have like a mask for your own self with your own product, which is quite good. I'm going to try that. So basically, as it says here, you know, wash your face, pour in enough liquid, just like any other thing, pour in enough liquid off your product, off your serum, and wait for it to expand. And then when it expands, it'll expand with all your serum or essence on it, and you can sit it on your face. But it's ideal when you don't want to drink a small size. So if you don't want to cut, if you're going on holiday or you're going somewhere, you're travelling, you don't have room for a mask, pop that in. If you're already taking your stuff with you, your essence or your serum, then you just pour it in. So I'll give a video on seeing how these actually work along with the towels. I bought this brightening mirror. $10 this one was, so about £5. There was a bigger one for £10 that opened up with the three, but I just decided to get this one. It doesn't come with batteries, I don't think. No, so it needs batteries, so I'll need to get batteries for that. So this is an LED one. On off button. Brightening LED mirror. Into getting batteries for that one. I'll get batteries for that and then we can give that one a go. What else did I get? Oh yeah, I got this one, which is the 3D mask. So these are quite good. These actually go on top of your existing sheet mask, or in the case of your normal facial mask. So in this one, what you do is you put your face mask on, and to stop it from evaporating, you stick this on top. So once you've stuck this on top, it should actually stop the mask from underneath evaporating, which will give you more more formula onto your skin, make your mask work a little bit better. So basically, it basically like kind of sucks into your face to keep the mask from moving. As you can see at the back. So you just put it onto your ears, you can cut it to adjust it, and it really just is stopping your previous mask from evaporating. So for $3.50 or $3. I think all in all, and my husband got some stuff, I think we spent about $80 in the store. So your $3.50 soon adds up when you start buying a lot of stuff. And just one final thing which I quite like, just because it's warm. I always like using, usually pick different ones, but my last one broke, is just a fan. Take this off. If I can get this bit off. And it's just a fan, which I think is quite a pretty wee fan. It's nice just to cool down, keep you cool, and it folds up quite neatly. These are great. I've had these for years. Keep these in my bag, especially in summer. Ideal if you're at work or if you're just out and about and it's hot, just pull out your fan, quick fan, and you kind of cool down a wee bit. So yeah, that was quite good. That was quite handy, put like that. So there we go, that was my quick pit stop into Daiso.